Turns out we've got a project that we're working on that requires a DI box, so we figured, rather than going to buy one, why not make one?
Oh hey, it actually worked!
We came up with a design right here that we like. Gonna use the Hammond 1140 DBA, which is a pro quality DI box transformer, to convert guitar signal into an XLR signal to run into a board.
You plug your guitar in, and then on this end, going out the XLR, you can go directly into a board. That's a dry signal. Or you can even use it as a splitter to go into an amp as well. You can do both. And this one's completely passive, so it doesn't require any power, which is good.
We're going to organize this just like a standard guitar pedal. So you'll have your in on one side and your out on the other, just a quarter inch out. And then the XLR is going to be on the top. That's what's going to send the signal out to the board. And we're going to throw in a ground lift, because you never know when you need to lift the ground.
It's a 35-year-old ruler.
Yeah, this thing's ancient. Pretty sure my wife had this in high school, and I commandeered it from the house. Drawing lines! Man, doing lines is my favorite pastime.
All marked up and ready to go.
Pieces of metal stabbed into my arm. Don't try this at home, at least not that way. You're really supposed to do this with a drill press, but we don't have a drill press here, so you work with what you got. Alright, so we got all our holes drilled, and what we're going to do is we're going to give it a few passes with some steel wool to scuff it up a little, clean it and scuff it up so it takes paint a little better, and we'll give it a wipe down just to get any wool residue and aluminum residue off of it, so that when we apply a coat of paint, it'll stick and stick really good. Alright, so we got them propped up on some really fancy cardboard apparatuses that we built so that we can paint all around the edges without it sticking to the drop cloth. Here we go!
Alright, let's put this thing together. So we picked up all the screws that we need at a local hardware store. If you're making one of these, that's what you're going to need to do. Measure it out, get some screws, some washers, some nuts, and go nuts.
Sponge was dry.
Sponge is now moist.
Yeah, there's way more wire than you need, just in case you screw up. Rin tin tin!
Hottest signal going into that board. Straight through a red box.
Well, actually, this does the opposite.
It was a joke.
Oh.
That's even better. Now it's ruined.
Just to give you a brief overview of when a DI box is not only useful, but necessary, and that's often in recording. So, here's a great example where we are recording directly into an interface, and a lot of interfaces, even these days, don't have the ability for you to plug your guitar directly into them. You should still be going through a DI box.
And the issue is primarily due to the impedance mismatch between the guitar and the input of your interface. It's not simply the input being peaked from too hot of a signal, which is what a lot of people mistakenly believe. I'll give you an example. This is the signal without the DI box. And then with the DI box. So you can hear right away a massive difference in clarity. There's an improvement in dynamics from the DI box. What a DI box does is it takes the input from your guitar at the impedance that it is at and essentially converts it to an impedance that the board or the interface will be able to accept without problems. I'll A/B the two again and I'll just go back and forth between them so you can hear side by side. So, buy one, build one, borrow one, whatever you need to do to get advantage of the DI box that you need in order to record your guitars, or play live, or any of the other uses for it. This is John from NextGen. Have a good one.